I believe that life should not be a life of compromise. I believe in being responsible. I believe in being safe. Yet I believe in thinking of out of the box options. And with these out of the box options, we can be safe, responsible, and still do whatever we want. This is what this series is going to cover. So like, I'll share one of the things what I mean when I say this. When it comes to hand sanitizers, which we will all have to start using as we start moving out of the house. Right now, we may not be using hand sanitizers because, of course, it makes much more sense to use water and soap rather than using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer if the option of water and soap is available. So I want to repeat this point with great clarity that if there are two options, one is using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer and other is using water and soap, I would want you to use water and soap if it is available and the alcohol-based hand sanitizer only if water and soap is not available. But yes, as we start stepping out, water and soap may not always be available and you will be using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer. And I will tell you what will happen if you overuse this alcohol-based hand sanitizer. But before that, I would also like to tell you that there are so many sanitizers available in the market, but you need to make sure that it contains good quality and high concentration of alcohol, because if the sanitizer is very dilute or contains very little of alcohol, because there are a lot of non-branded sanitizers available. So if you end up using a non-branded sanitizer and think that you have hygienic hands now that you have used a sanitizer, you may be in a false sense of security. Not all sanitizers are FDA approved. So please look for a good quality sanitizer. Even your doctor could help you find a good quality sanitizer. Even I could help you find a good quality sanitizer, because doctors are also using sanitizers extensively in their clinics. Here, I would also want you to say that when you start stepping out and if you start using the sanitizers used at a lot of public places, so all public places will have a sanitizer dispenser and you might be using them, but I am not sure which place is using what quality of a sanitizer. Some people may just dilute the sanitizer and keep it there. So I would recommend that you carry your own small bottle of a sanitizer that your doctor has recommended to you, that you know is definitely a good quality sanitizer, because I don't want you to be in a false sense of security. I don't want you to be paranoid or over careful. At the same time, I don't want you to be careless and in a false sense of security. So the right blend is where there's balance. All you need is a few drops of a verified, right quality, pharma grade sanitizer and use your own. Does this make sense?